On first down, Newton. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line.
Didn't have the greatest field position to start, did they? And now after this sack, it's way, way worse.
And right off the bat, first play of the game. To throw on second down is Newton. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1-yard line. End zone, Brissett. And his first look is incomplete. He was going for the tight end, Nick Vanette. And that'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
And he'll find Sutton on the right side, complete. And all the way up to the 49. A big play there on the catch and run. 48 yards.
Trying to defend a drag route is really tough because you don't want to jump a route as shorter or underneath as the drag route is too quickly, because oftentimes they want to run that route and then hit over the top of you for bigger yardage. So if you can chip off the timing of the receiver off the line of scrimmage so he can't actually get into the route, that's the best way to defend it. But there was no possibility of that on that play. End result, receiver won in a big way.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll throw again, Brissett. And down he goes, brought down a Raider sack. Jonathan Hankins forcing his way through there to drop him for a loss of a good 10 yards. It's third and long for Brissett. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation.
I thought he did a pretty good job there to get back what he could, but let's face it, that sack on second down, talk about throwing a wrench into the works. He certainly did.
Yeah, he did everything he could there, trying to pick up some positive yardage, and he did, but not enough. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line. The Raiders' offense now. Trot back out, and on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
To throw is Newton. That one complete to D.D. Westbrook. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. He got 29 yards that time. Now a first down throw for Newton. And that is incomplete here. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
On second and 10, Newton. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. The Broncos say they have it. They do. And hopefully for both sides, not a sign of things to come, Charles. This morning, it was so perfect outside, but we knew this weather was coming, and we see the effects of it here early on.
And I wonder if how perfect it was this morning has psychologically fooled everyone. You know, it's almost like even though we were told the weather was coming, and you know the teams knew it as well, and maybe they got fooled and thought, ah, it's going to be okay. And now they're probably a little upset that it's out there.
Because warm-ups were dry.
Oh, well, dry. Now you've got to make the change up, and it's the first quarter. Might take them a little time to settle in on their focus and concentration.
Throwing again, Brissett on second and 10. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward, incomplete pass. On third down, Brissett. And that will be incomplete as well. It was the free safety, LaMarcus Joyner, that time, able to make the play.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
First quarter only, but they're 0 for 2 on third down conversions to start this thing. It's a 43-yard punt, a return of 5, and the Raiders will take over now first and 10. A good starting spot for the Raiders as they come up first and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton. He's going to air one out. This is caught at the 20. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. And that one results in 35 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
On second down, here's Newton. And Brown's got it for an Oakland touchdown. Antonio Brown from 13 yards out, and the Raiders have taken the early lead. Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bronco offense now set to come back out onto the field. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Offensively, might be thinking, what's going on here? One for their first 7 throwing the football.
So maybe they're thinking about rethinking their strategy a little bit right now with the way that they're throwing it around, not having that success. Might have to lean on the running game for a little while and see if they can get him back in form.
Line of scrimmage, again, the 25, second and 10. Play action, Brissett. And the Raiders have got him. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Brissett from the gun on third. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. That's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from him. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. 12 yards on the return that time, and the Raiders will have a short field to work with as they take over. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Tackled by Bradley Chubb, the number 5 pick in the 2018 draft.
We saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football. They've got a second down and 8 to start things out. From the gun, here's Newton. And his throw is going to be incomplete. DeeDee Westbrook, his intended receiver, and it's third down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on 3rd and 8. Out of the gun, Newton. Buying time to his left. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Newton's Super Bowl nemesis, Von Miller. Able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be 4th down. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
And Denver getting set to take the field. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither's...
And oh, they coughed it up! And fortunately, he's able to get this one back, so it is a 1st down.
All I can say about this play is that someone's living right. I mean, he's trying to gain yardage, trying to get upfield. Ball comes free. What's that panic that we've talked about oftentimes that you feel when you lose the ball?
You can sense it.
Oh, you can sense it. And somehow he got to it and was able to recover it for his squad.
Looking for more there on 1st down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Danny Trevathan there to bring him down.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative. Now, you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and set them down.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Raiders. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that.
He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. A shotgun snap for Newton. Man up the left side is Brown. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. On first down, it's Newton. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The former first-round pick, Kareem Jackson, there defensively.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Now it's Newton. That's into the hands of Westbrook over the middle. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. And that one results in 35 yards. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. A first down carry now for Crowell. He'll get it to the 23-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Not too many more ideal situations in second and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
From the red zone now, Newton. Dancing to his, and he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
After the sack here, second and 11. From the gun, Newton. A throw left side, complete to his receiver, Westbrook. And now the Broncos will burn another time. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Operating from the gun, Newton. And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. As his guys are in for 6, and the Raiders add on to their lead. Oh, it's a fake. They'll try and throw for it.
The defense is doing their best, but they're struggling right now. They'll look for some help from their own offense to keep them in the game. Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare them to do that?
I was
going to
ask you, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film when those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Flex round! They go play action here on first down. He sets to fire deep. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
And Brandon, the passing game for both of these teams is going to be affected as the game goes along. It's not looking like the rain's going to let up anytime soon. So that might mean a few more wobbly passes and wide receiver slips. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
Now following the interception, here's Newton. He rifles one that's intercepted. Sua Cravens with a pick. And he will score. Touchdown, Denver.
You think you're going into halftime with a good-sized lead? Not so fast. That pick six really changes the complexion, probably also changes the halftime speech.
No doubt about it. Instead of going in relaxed, you're probably a little more uptight right now, probably a little bit angry. Let's see if they can get their focus back.
Out of the gun, Brissett steps away to his left. And he is in for the 2 points, and they're back within a score as the lead's cut to 8. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now here come the Raiders. Pick six. It's Newton. And the Broncos get there and take him down.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
Here's Newton now on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. The quick slant, good for a first down, a gain of 12. Back to throw, Newton. And it's complete. The tight end, Deion Sims. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Newton on first down. And his throw here is incomplete. Deion Sims is tied in the intended target. And now it's second down.
Well, so many times defensive backs get caught playing the man rather than the football. But not in this case. That's an excellent play. Did exactly what you're supposed to do. Attack the football and help break up the pass.
Yep, as a result, knocks it down. Throw left side complete. That's Sims. He got 29 yards that time. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
I think the last 2 plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy, because you know you can throw the...
And Brown's got it for a Raider touchdown. Cam Newton with his 3rd touchdown pass of this first half. And the Raiders add 6 to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And Denver getting set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. A second down throw for Brissett. He's going to look deep down the field. And this will be caught at the 30. And he's going to have this down deep into Oakland territory. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. And Hopkins' kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage 3 here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
So we are halfway home to figuring out who will represent the AFC in the Super Bowl. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports Halftime Report. One more half to decide who takes home the Lamar Hunt Trophy as we're back underway in this AFC Championship. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to...
system. Hoping I ain't lose religion. Text and prayer hands. Hope the message sending on. Know I've been blessed. I've been seeing prophets. Musty yellow shirts. Louder than the broccoli. Dancing in my chucks. Living out of body. Say to say the man got me.
Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now?
I'm kissing. Why my extensions? I don't look like expeditions. Man, it's too loud. Hit me in your city. Cause when I start spitting too much drive, need some power steering. Cruising to a better vision. Yup.
Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Mama, dirty the roads that I've traveled, but I'm...
Thank you, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Oakland, California. Straight ahead, it's a clash to decide the AFC's representative in the Super Bowl. And it'll be a great one between the Denver Broncos and the Oakland Raiders. The winner here goes to the Super Bowl, and we'll know soon enough which team that'll be as we are underway in the AFC title game. That's fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. This is taken at the 15. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. And 10, Brissett. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. Second down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. On second down, Brissett again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Denver has the first down. The play going for 15 yards. Brissett on first down. And an alley to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Emmanuel Sanders, 48 yards, and the Broncos have taken the early lead. I think that's the dream start right there. The defense stands up on the opening drive, then they go right down the field and score.
It's a positive start for your offense and your defense. And when you're talking about playoff football, what a great way to get things going.
Everything is magnified and amped up a little bit more.
To put it mildly.
And that'll be incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. I would say they went 3-and-out last time, but actually they didn't even get to 3-and-out. Still a strange decision to us here in the booth.
Yeah, let's hope they don't go 1-and-out, but maybe, possibly, let's try and think with them here. Try and play field position maybe, turn the ball over, put it in the hands of their defense. Who knows?
You're a nice man. No gain on the play there, second down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
On second down, here's Crowell. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough 9. They've had touchdowns on both of their drives thus far, but now they face a third and long. Throwing on third down, Newton. Open man is Westbrook, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. From the gun, Newton. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Shaq back at about the 43-yard line. The man who won a Super Bowl MVP award across the bay in Santa Clara, Von Miller. In there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Over the middle here to Brown. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
Newton now to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. On second and 10, Newton flush to his right. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. The improv act there, good for 9. And now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and 1.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. This will be play number 7 on the drive, 3rd and a yard. They'll try to run for it with Crowell. And a short gain here, down to the 22. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be 4th down and a few inches. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll wind up with about 6 up past the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he can even get started. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Brissett. Flushed out right. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. Tally, that is catch number 1 for him in this AFC championship. It's a 1st down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a 1st down.
Here's Brissett being chased out left. And avoids the contact by sliding. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Looking for Sanders here on the deep ball. And his throw will be intercepted. Nevin Lawson with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will play. From the end zone, Newton. He's going deep for Brown. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at 2nd down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
They'll throw again from their own end zone. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. When you're on your own one-yard line like they were, oftentimes you're thinking just run on any down, get some space. There they elect to throw it. It cost them.
You get the sense that they were banking on the element of surprise.
And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Whitney Merciless leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six. Second down, Brissett. Finding room to the 20. He'll find Sutton on the right side, complete. Second catch of this AFC title game, but he's got a first down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have...
And caught by Sanders. Touchdown, Broncos. Emmanuel Sanders, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. And now the offense is going to stay out there as the Broncos will go for two. They're going to try and run. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. And he is going to be stopped short of the goal line. Oh, they'll mark him inside the one. He just couldn't keep churning those extra few inches. And the two-point attempt is turned aside. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They begin with a run by Corral, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Takes this to the 27, give him 4 yards.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Third down, Newton looking left side, that's caught by Landry. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
That goes in the category of a play that the defense is going to cherish and excites them. A completion, yes, you give up the pass, but no gain. I mean, that's exactly what you want on defense.
And sets up the fourth down. And now running right through it. So a change of possession here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And Denver getting set to take the field. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Brissett to throw on first. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. He got 29 yards that time. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 41. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there, and now it's third down and inches. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. To play here in the first half. Back with more of the AFC Championship game after this. They'll try and sneak it here. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. Only a yard there on the keeper, but that's all he needed. First down. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. From the red zone now, Brissett. And caught by Sanders. Touchdown, Broncos. Emmanuel Sanders saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Broncos will extend their lead. Whoa! He just yanked that one well to the left and no good. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And it'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Obi Melifonwu. And he will not get all the way home, but he will take this back down to about the 2-yard line. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
From the gun, here's Brissett. They'll roll him out right. So unable to will throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst. And if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this one is incomplete. Trying to get it there to D.D. Westbrook. That'll bring up second down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. Only way to play good defense.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
It's been my observation. There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They are going to go for it. It's Newton. That's into the hands of Westbrook over the middle. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. As they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. From the gun, here's Newton. Trying to lay one up deep. And Brown's got it. Touchdown, Raiders. Antonio Brown, 51 yards. And the Raiders get a score closer.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in a second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that cuts the lead to 24-10. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So the Broncos coming out now. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll throw now on the final play. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. So we come upon halftime in the AFC title game. As we'll see.